Welcome back to PGA Chain Design. While I was doing research for making a video, I found the pasta shape has so many different kinds and a lot of them are very interesting. So today we are going to talk about the three different types of a pasta shape. Are you ready? Let's get started. Before we start today's tutorial, I would like to invite you to join the membership program, or you can find under every video on the right button next to the subscribe. You'll be bringing into this little window to show you what the membership is and what is included. That is support my passion to help many people to learn jewelry design. Okay, back to our pasta. I am amazed there are so many different kinds of pasta I cannot even keep track of, so I'm not going to pronounce the name. I probably will pronounce wrong. If I have fans from Italy, you may can help us a little bit here. But let's go back to the model. I would like to talk about three different kind of pasta today, and the shape is very similar. They all kind of have a volume, have the texture on it. We are going to talk about each of them. That's starting with the first one. For the first one here, we kind of noticed there's two different kind of the outline there. One on the top is caving a little bit and it's a smaller on the bottom, it's a little bit bigger. So we are going to starting with the front view, and let's draw an arc first. And coming over here, we have a rail for us to creating the surface. So that's coming into the perspective. We're gonna look at the bottom one, and we're going to creating an oval. And on the top, I'm going to create another oval, but it's just a little bit smaller. Okay, so if you trying to turn on the control point and you want to edit, and you'll notice that it coming into the kink because this is a degree 2 curve. So what I like to do is I would like to change both of them by using the commands called rebuild. And we want to rebuild them with the same number for 8, but want to make sure the degree is 3. They may not be like perfect oval, but it's actually perfect in our case for the pasta because they actually not coming into the perfect size. Then let's give it a try to making a surface. We wanted to try with the sweep one rail, and this is a rail, this is a cross section. We also try to, I always like to move them into inside because that has a less impact if I need to do additional editing. Then we want to record a history. So we kind of get a shape like that, and if you don't like the shape, you feel like I need to tweak a little bit, you can make them wider or make them bigger or whichever you think will fitting into your pasta outline, or you can simply to make this cave a little bit more so you can kind of tweak it into you find a shape that you like. Once we like it, we are going to delete this one because that's just for us to pre-see or review what it's going to look like. We're going to deal with the bump in two different ways. I'm going to show you one way with this pasta, and I will show you another way with the third pasta. That's creating a circle and starting with this quadrant. Roughly look like this, and depends on how big you want the texture to be. And we are going to use the command, it's called array along curve, and we're going to pick up this object, enter, and let's pick up the path here. Make sure the orientation is freeform, and let's try number 22 there. Okay, so that looked nice for the distance over there. I'm going to move this up with the gumbo and making the copy by tapping the Alt key, and want to scale it down smaller, something like that. And we're going to do the same number on the array along the curve. So array along curve, pick up the object, enter, and pick up the path. And let's try again number 22. Okay, so now we have everything that we needed. We are going to use the command, it's called curve boolean. And we are coming to inside of it and just click inside. And you're going to get the curve is like this. Okay, and we're just gonna hide this curve, and let's pick up the original curve and hide it, and now we can delete everything else. If we turn it back on, and this is what we have, like one of this and one of this. Okay, we are going to do exactly the same thing. Let's pick up all of them, curve bowling, and we want to pick up inside of it, and let's select this curve and the curve that we made and hide it, and we can delete all of this circle. Okay, so now we have something like this. I usually like my curve to be degree 3, so I'm going to rebuild this one and see how many points that we have so far. We got 202, so let's do 202 on both of them. Even though it appeared to be a lot of points, but at least I can make sure it is a closed curve. You won't have any break or things like that. We are going to use the sweep one rail, and it's going to go from here to here. And I always like to align my seam in the interior or in the middle, and then we will get the shape here. Okay, let's go ahead and make it solid by using the CAD command, and we are going to scale this down a little bit for whatever thickness that you want and move it out a little bit. This one too, we are going to scale it down for whatever thickness, or you can use the offset to get exactly the same thickness, right? And we are going to use the sweep one again. This is the rail. We're gonna go from here to here. And again, align to interior here and over here. All right, so then we get another shape. We can use the CAD command one more time. And all we need to do is bowling difference this one out of this one. So then we got a hollow shape with this texture on this type of a spaghetti. Let's take a look on the second one. The second one we have seems is really close to the first one. It's just the first, it is the cross section is actually from round one to round one. However, it does twist a little bit. All right, so this is a really interesting form as well. And they also have that macaroni kind of arc there. So we are gonna start in with the arc to see how curve that you want on this piece. So let's say we're gonna have something like that. And we are going to type in the command called length. And to know how long is this line is 16.313. So let's draw a line for 16.313 here. Okay, so that means if this arc to straighten straight, and that will be this straight line there. Okay, so again, let's do a circle right in the middle. Let's take a look on this view and see how big you want it there. Okay, and again, we wanted to do the same thing like we did. We want to make the texture by giving the first circle there. All right, since this is a circle, it will be a little bit easier by just using the polar array. So we're going to polar array this guy. Center polar array will be the center of the circle, and let's try 22, and that's a little bit too many, so let's try 18. It might be the peak over there might be too narrow, so let's try 15 there. Okay, it's looking good there. And then we wanted to do is again curve bowling. We want to pick up everybody, and we actually want to click inside, so that will give us this curve here. So I'm going to hiding this curve, and then I'm going to delete all the circle there. And I'm going to shrinking the circle just a little bit, and that will be the thickness of that. And this look too much like a gear looking thing, so let's just rebuild it to make it nice and rounder. The preset is 92, let's just stay with the 92. And you notice that it will give you a little bit irregular shape, but it's okay, it's a spaghetti. Okay, it actually will look more natural. If you feel like this is still like too gear looking things, you may come back and rebuild again, and by reducing the number, maybe like 85. Oh, maybe like 80, And you're gonna notice that they kind of rounded there. So I'm gonna click OK for that. So give me some sort of an irregular shape. So we're gonna come over here, select both of them, and we wanna extrude it, that planar curve, all the way to the end like that. So that will be our spaghetti. Okay, so to make it twist, we are gonna use the twist command. Gonna pick up this surface, and we're gonna go from here to here, and coming into the right view. You don't have to twist a lot, but something like that should be fine. Okay, so now once we have that, we are kind of coming into the transform, and we have a one called flow along curve. So this is the object, this is the base point, and this is the target point. So then we will get the pasta look like this. This will be our second pasta. For the third one, this is shell looking things. We are gonna have a different approach to making the texture. That's starting with the arc here. So I'm going to use the second arc from start end and the point of the arc to decide the shape of my pasta. So they may look something like this. It doesn't have to be exactly the same, all right? And then we're gonna come over onto the perspective, and that's using the third one. The arc is the start end and direction of the arc. We're gonna snap in here and here, and coming into the right view, holding my shift, so I will have the arc like that. Doing the same thing on the top. You may want to do another one right in the middle. And the reason I wanted to do that is because I want this like a little bit undercut, so puff it out a little bit. So we need to rebuild this curve into 5. And then so instead of trying to draw it, I will just scale 1D with the gumbo on that arc. All right, so everything looked nice there. Let's go ahead to rebuild everybody into 5 point. Okay, and let's give it a try by using the sweep tool. Rail 1, rail 2, cross section, go 1, 2, 3. And then we get this beautiful, beautiful form. Okay, so now I need to make them into the thickness. So I would like to do is to offset, and that's offset outside, so let's flip all over, and in this case the thickness that stay with the 1, and you can see I have, you know, the other shape here. All right, so for this one it's a little bit irregular. Let's rebuild this one. We want to rebuild into U will be 20, V will be 5, and let's click OK. Alright, so what it does is, you see we have like really regular contour line there, and we are going to use the command under the curve, that you have curve on the object, and this one's called extract wireframe. So we're gonna pick up this surface and extract the wireframe, and once we extract it, and let me hide it this one so it's easier for us to see. Alright, so you see the curve that we have. We actually don't need this curve, and we don't need this curve as well. And also let me hiding the original curve we have. You usually don't want to delete the original curve just in case you need to do something later on. Okay, so with all of this, we are going to use the commands called pipe. And let's pipe it, in my case, for 0.35 in radius. Okay, so now let's bring back whatever we have there. Okay, if the texture distance is what you like, that we are going to stay with it. Let's make this one into solid first. So I'm going to use the blend command. Under the surface, you have blend surface. Let's blend this one to this one. And so we get something like nice and puffy. If you feel like this is too much, you can always bring it down. All right, let's do it again on the other side, starting from this to this. And again, if you feel like it's too puffy, you can always bring it down. Okay, so we can always join it first, and now we just need to deal with this opening. I'm going to use the sweep tool rail, and you got the rail 1, you got rail 2, and cross section for this arc and this arc. We're gonna do it one more time on the other side, rail 1, and rail 2 is right inside. And you want to choose the cross section with this arc and cross section with this arc. Let's go ahead to join everybody. Okay, so now we can do our bowling. We're gonna do the bowling difference. The first one is the shell, the rest of it is the rest of the pipe. Then that's how we get this texture there. I hope you enjoy my experiment on the pasta shape here. It's kind of fun. I may do more if you guys like it. So leave the comments, let me know what you think. Thank you, and hope to see you in the membership program. See you next.